Hello, Dr. Ron Eaglin. I'm going to take you through a complex database example. So follow closely. I'm going to go through it relatively fast, and I'll show you what I want to do. First, I've got a big flat set of raw data. This is a big raw data set, and this is what the data looks like. And I've got coded fields. So the fields themselves, like in this case, the fields that we're going to look at are ACR and FS in this example. ACR stands for acreage. FS stands for food stamps. And what I want to know here is that for every combination of acreage, how many people are on food stamps and how many people are not on food stamps? So that can lead to a relatively complex query. Well, the first thing that I'm going to do when I'm solving this is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to create some lookup tables. And I'm going to show you a couple ways of doing the lookup tables. So the first combination of lookup tables I'm going to show you is creating a separate lookup table for every coded field. So in other words, every field in here has its own separate lookup table. So to do that, I'm going to run over here to, I had it in one of these query combinations that I have here, but let's just create a new query. Select star from ACR. Whoops. Okay. I have to use Florida Housing DB, go there. That is a lookup table. Select star from ACR. This is only contains two pieces of information, a code. The code corresponds with the code in the raw data that you saw, one or two or three in this case, okay, and the actual description that goes with this, which I actually had to pull from the data dictionary, and I created these tables. Have another lookup table for FS. And FS has two values, essentially yes or no. There are no NAs, but that was added to take care of the fact that if you did have an NA, you could handle it. So if I want to create a query where it shows me for every acreage, how many food stamps do I have, okay, that's what this would look like. Well, using that way of doing it, how can I do this? So I'm going to find the right query here. I don't need this anymore, so I'll get rid of it. And I don't need this anymore, so I can get rid of it. Okay. Okay, so here is this query. I'll take you through it relatively straightforward. This is an aggregation query. And what an aggregation says, the aggregation field is description. You can tell it because it has the group by on this. So ACR.description is the aggregation field. And what this means, when you see a group by, it says for every value of description, execute the query and show the results. So what I'm going to do is I have a second field here that's going to count. It's going to count how many records you actually have that match the conditions. So the conditions that we're looking at here are, one, that food stamps is equal to 2, okay? That's food stamps equals no, and the raw data acreage equals the acreage in the aggregation. Remember, I said for every value of this, show me how many counts I have here. Well, description and code are 1-to-1. So on the description that I'm going to actually put as my output, you're going to have a value that goes with the code, and it can aggregate on those. So it's saying, for description equals house on less than 1 acre, find the code, and for that code, tell me how many number of units I've got. For the next value of description that I've got, do the same thing again. For the third value of description I've got, do the same thing again. The second end field, rawdata.fs equals fs.code, well, that's going to be simple because fs is equal to a constant, which is 2. I can set fs equal to 1 and rerun it, and it will show me for every situation where fs is equal to yes, because a 1 corresponds with yes. That's how that works. And think about that. As an aggregation, you're going to go through every value. The group by is going to go through every value of the field that you have in the aggregation, the group by aggregation, and show you what the results of the query are. Okay, well, that's great. We've shown that that works pretty well. I'm not going to actually close that yet. So now, I'm going to have another way of going through this aggregation. Okay, I'm going to get rid of the raw data here so I've got a little bit of room. So I can see them. I can what this requires you to do is it requires you to have a separate lookup table for every field in the raw data. So that's a lot of lookup tables. Okay. Well, I don't have to do that. I can have two tables combined to show all the lookup information, and I call that categories and codes. Okay. If I do that, okay, for categories and codes, and I will actually go over here and I'll take the categories and codes table so you can see them. Okay. First, we're looking at the categories. Well, I only put four categories in this table, but categories is the name of each category and the description that goes with that category. So you saw that ACR was a field in the raw data which had its own category, which is lot size. Okay, the same thing with FS, which is yearly food stamp supplemental assistance. Okay, that's the categories. The codes look essentially the same. The codes actually are correspond with a category, but the codes are the individual codes that can be with each category. So if I looked at ACR, there are in the codes three possible combinations with the NA in there. 1, 2, and 3 is the code that you have in the raw data. ACR is the corresponding category, and then the description that goes with each of those. And it's relatively straightforward to say, you know what, I can also show star, okay, and I can show the categories, and I can combine them two together if I can type. Okay, and it's just a little bit of copy and paste. I'm gonna go ahead and set them. Category name. So the code's category name combines to go with that, and wait, I got categories is actually gonna be invalid because I need to put the whole thing in there. And there's combining the two together. And they're easy to relatively straightforward to combine together. But you can see that you've got codes can be mapped to the categories. All right, so let's go and get rid of that. And I've actually got lectures on that. So now, if I'm going to do it this method, where I don't have a separate lookup table for every single column in the database, the raw data, and I'm just going to use two tables, categories and codes, I can still aggregate. So in this case, my aggregation is on codes.description, but in the case of codes.description, I want the category name of the codes.description to be ACR. So I only want to go through the codes.description where the category name is ACR. So it's going to go through just the acreage categories. And it's going to go through each description that you have for the code. There's three of them. Okay, 1, 2, and 3. We knew that there were three because there were three before. Okay. And now I'm going to go ahead and set the raw data ACR equal to the codes.name and the raw data.fs equal to 2. Or I can do it equal to 1. Either way, it's going to work. So the conditions that you had in the first query still apply. The raw data.fs is equal to a value, and the raw data.ACR is going to go through the aggregation operator, the one that you see each value for. You have to add in this other one here, this other AND clause, because you have to join the codes and the categories tables together to do this, because you've got to look up every code for each for a specific individual category. But the aggregation still has the same exact concept. So the queries are essentially equivalent. Important points here. Lookup tables and how to work with lookup tables. Lookup tables can be individual lookup tables for every field, or it can be done as a series of two tables for categories and codes. An aggregation operator will go through every single one of the things in the aggregation and the group by, and for each of those, run the query and give you the results of the query, which in this case, the results of the query are outputting the count of how many there are and gives you the output. Hopefully this has been very useful to you. It's relatively complex stuff, but aggregation, queries, and lookup tables all together. Thank you very much and good programming.